And this year, except Train and Coke in California, for Mr. and Mrs. Jimmy Johnson, or afterwards Mrs. Van Lennep. And Cole got lame after Rachel once back east early in June. And he didn't race again until the Hamiltonian the week before Steph training in 2-2 for the Hamiltonian. I'd step right there with Hootenhorn. And that was a pretty good job of getting the horse ready to go three heats without having to race. And the favorite in that race was, one favorite was Rodney, who he beat that day. But Sepp did win a $3,000 race with him, a stake with him in California that year. And he was second to Rodney on June 20th before he got lame. Hamiltonian that year was raised August 6, 1947 for $6,000. Hootenhorn was 2-1-1. Rodney was 5-5 time, was 1-2-2. Way Yonder, Phil Fleming got him for Gainsway Farm, was 8-3-3. Upshot B, Frank Safford was 3-6-4. And it was 7 money winners that year. He was nominated for Award Day only $50. Now you see him leading. And this heat, Rodney won. 2-1-2 with the last quarter and just 30 seconds. But Sepp went away, and I read where Sepp said he timed and won the piece and came from behind to win the second heat. But this is the first heat that Vi Chavez won. Now there's Vi right there with Rodney. Clint Hart was driving in the race with Scott Thistle and Bolo Stone. Fred Egan had. I think that might have been Grand Parade, the one on the outside there with Terry Fitzpatrick. But you'll see some horse there made it. No, it's hot. Yeah, that was Sepp on the outside. Looked like he made a break and caught, but you can see Vi won it pretty easily with Rodney, and Sepp was second. Now you can see Vi after winning the first heat there. Funny, Mr. Fellow Fraser sold and sold him the Castle and Farm for $50,000. Then after, next year, Castle sold him the Hanover Shoe Farm where he stood all his life. And they sold him for $50,000 after winning the Hamiltonian. Fred Egan had him the year before, and I don't know why. I guess Fred just, well, they thought he couldn't beat Rodney or something, but they did sell him for $50,000. There you can see the old Good Time Park track. A lot of shade up there. Just one of the unfortunate things that it was moved away from there when it was. See, there's Vi on top again with Rodney, but Hootenhorn comes right around this time, and that's Del Cameron in there third. And you'll see Hootenhorn just tries fine. You see the old street behind. There's right back there. You can see Fred Egan's old barn, well, he just stayed all that night. He came to come to the bike where the grandstand and the awnings were. There you get a pretty good look at the crowd, and there's Steph. Kind of buggy riding in 2 minutes. And to death, afterwards he signed in 59. Now here in the 30s, that was the Smith barrier, you know, that was on the track and inside of the track. And I think a horse would lead better from the outside than it could be from the rail, because the outside swing came across in front of the horses. There's the old front turn. This is pretty sharp. It's kind of a three-turn track. It's a turn there, then a, you can see it's kind of a sharp, another real big first turn. And then it comes down the back stretch, kind of the other stretch. And you come into another pretty sharp turn right there where they're going around now. Then we're on up towards Fred's barn. And there it is. He's coming out, he turns around. That's Jeff Cameron again. Five in third. I think that's Fred in the two hole. And then you had another turn right around there before you came home. So there's really three turns on a mile track. If they had a good long stretch, it was helpful. If you didn't get out there, you hardly ever get out in any stretch. So Bi tried him again, but the big old horse couldn't make it that way. He was a good trotter too. So there's the winner there, Koopman. You'll see the winner circle, and you'll see Francis and Jimmy Johnson. And in those days, Doc Baker from around Hamburg, New York, had been announced. There was a caretaker, I knew him well. And you'll see Mr. Harriman come up and shake hands with Steph. That's Mr. Harriman right there. That's Doc Baker right there. And some of the others I don't recognize. Jimmy and Francis Baker was happy as a lark. I don't blame her. She's a wonderful sportswoman, and she was great for our game. Thought that nice farm of cattle and got it back. And she and Freddie kept it. I mean, just made a great breeding establishment out of it. I don't know whether that was on the governor, the politician, or I haven't seen Mr. Phillips, but there's Jimmy. And you can see the Hamiltonian trophy. In those days, it's Joe DeGosian. He's brought to eat all the time, racing daytime. There's Roger Duncan, that one time president of the USA, right behind Francis' left shoulder. Roger Duncan came from around Hartford. That's the end of 1947 Hamiltonian.